Often, when using UI elements in a scene, we want them to be interactable. A user interacts with UI elements via events. This lesson covers generating and handling those events. Whenever a canvas is created in a scene, an event system game object is also created. This game object has components, including an event system component and one or more input module components. When a scene starts, the event system looks for input modules on the same game object and uses those to define how each UI element should react to input. The event system itself has one property, first selected. All interactable UI elements can be selected, and whichever element is applied to this property will be selected by default when the scene starts. We could, for example, apply a button to this property. Then, when we start the scene, we can see that it has changed color slightly, indicating that it is selected. When we press the spacebar, we see that the button becomes pressed without needing to click on it with the mouse. This is useful for non-pointer-based menu systems, such as those used with gamepads. Along with the event system components, there are, by default, two input modules, one for standalone builds that make use of the mouse, keyboard, or gamepads, and one for touch input. The standalone input module has a series of properties that refer to the different input axes used for navigating different interactable UI elements. These input axes include the submit and cancel buttons. These have been added by default to the input manager. For more information on navigating between interactable UI elements, please see the information linked below. The frequency of input being registered can be changed using the input actions per second property. By default, 10 input actions are allowed per second. This means that there will be a tenth of a second delay after an input action before the next action is accepted. The last property allows you to accept standalone input while on a mobile device. By default, the standalone input module will not function on a mobile device. Since touch input works like mouse input, there are no navigation axes. However, like the standalone input module, you can activate the touch input module while on a standalone device. The event system and input modules determine when events are sent or fired to different game objects. One such event is the on-click event, which is called when a button is pressed. Specifically, the selected button must have a pointer down and a subsequent pointer up event while over the button's rect for an on-click event to occur. For details on all of the input events, see the documentation linked below. There are many ways to use these events. Some interactable UI elements have function lists on their components that are called when a specific event pertinent to that element is fired. For example, button components have lists of functions to be called when the on-click event is fired. To catch a specific event that is not listed on a component by default, use the event trigger component. This works like any of the other lists for other components. However, the event trigger component can have multiple lists for whichever events are desired. For instance, an image control does not utilize any specific events. To allow it to use events with the event trigger component, first add the component by clicking Add Component, and then Event, and then Event Trigger. To add a new event, click the Add New button. This will give you a list of all of the different available events to catch. Select one of the events, and a list for that event will be added to the component. To add a function to the list, click the plus icon. This will create an empty entry for a function to be called. Drag an object that you wish to manipulate with this event onto the object property in the list. Once the object has been applied, the dropdown will be populated with all of the available functions to be called. As you can see, many components have functions that you can call with these events. You can even call functions on scripts that you write. In order for an event to call a function, that function must be public, have a void return type, and take one or no parameters. If the function has a parameter, it must be one of the following types: float, integer, string, or an object reference. And that's it. Your event is set up and ready to go.